Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to give your photos a dreamy romantic effect and then add text to it to personalize them. This effect also works especially well on portraits. I provided this image of Bokeh Lights that we'll use later in this video. Its link is located in the video description or project files. Open a photo you'd like to use. I downloaded this photo from Shutterstock.com. The size of this document is 1550 pixels wide by 870 pixels high and has a resolution of 150 pixels per inch. In the Layers panel, click the Adjustment Layer icon and choose Gradient Map. Change the Blend Mode to Screen. Click the Gradient Bar, which opens the Gradient Editor. Click the Violet-Orange preset. These colors work well on most photos, but for this example, I'll tweak them a bit. Click the lower left stop, the color box, and type in 32224C. Then, click OK or press Enter or Return. Click the lower right stop, the color box, and type in F8A658. Then, press Enter or Return on both the color picker and the gradient editor. Click the Adjustment Layer icon again, and this time choose Levels. Drag the input blacks a little left of where the histogram starts to rise. This will slightly darken the darkest colors. Drag the input midtones to the left to lighten them. Adding a soft, warm color next to the subject's face or shoulder is an effective way to add an illuminating, naturalistic light effect. To do this, click the New Layer icon to make a new layer and open your brush tool. Choose a large brush. For this document, I'll choose a brush size of 800 pixels. Depending on the size and resolution of your photo, you may want to adjust the amount of your brush size. Make the hardness 0% and press Enter or Return. Make sure the opacity is 100%. Press the F5 key at the top of your keyboard to open your brush panel and make sure the only setting checked is smoothing. Press F5 again to close the panel. Click the foreground color and type in FFD43D. Then, click OK or press Enter or Return. Press B to open your brush tool. Make sure your caps lock key is turned off. Otherwise, you won't be able to see your brush on your screen. Now, left click once next to your subject's head and change the blend mode to screen. Next, we'll add the bokeh lights to further enhance the overall effect. Open the bokeh file I provided. Press Ctrl or Command A to select it, and Ctrl or Command C to copy it. Open back up your photo, and press Ctrl or Command V to paste the bokeh lights into your document. Let's say your original photo is vertical and much larger. To transform the bokeh lights to a vertical angle, and to increase its size, press Ctrl or Command T to open your transform tool. Go to a corner, and when you see a curved double arrow, hold down Shift as you rotate it 90 degrees. Then, go back to a corner, and when you see a straight 45 degree double arrow, hold down Shift and drag it out until it completely covers your document. Then, press Enter or Return. If you need to zoom out, press Z to open your Zoom tool and hold down Alt or Option as you click on your document. Press Ctrl or Command 0 to fit your document back on your screen. Change the blend mode to screen. As I toggle back and forth, you can see the difference. We're ready to set our text. Open your horizontal type tool and pick a handwritten font. For this example, I'm using a font called Jenna Sue. If you'd like to use it, I provided its link as well. I'll type in 72 points for the size, smooth, and left alignment. Click on the color box and pick a dark color that complements the colors in your photo. For this image, I'll type in 57062B, then press Enter or Return. Type out your main text. With this font, you can type out a heart shape by pressing Shift plus the number 6. To reposition it, open your Move tool and move it. Click the FX icon and click Outer Glow. The blend mode is screen and the opacity is 75%. Click the color box and pick white. I'll make the size 27 pixels. Keep in mind, you may want to adjust this amount depending on the size and resolution of your photo. As I toggle back and forth, you can see that the glow makes the text stand out a bit more. Click on your document to make your secondary line of text. If it's a long line, reduce the size and type out your text. Open your Move tool to reposition it. We'll copy the outer glow effect to your secondary line of text. To do this, hold down Alt or Option as you drag the effects copy to the top layer. Double-click on Outer Glow to open it in the Layer Style window. Change the opacity to 50%. For the size and resolution of this photo, I'll make the spread 7% and the size 57 pixels. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.